We hope you are as excited and anxious as we are to explore technology options for people with disabilities. There are many people who can and should be supported to live more independently, and some of the options we will see showcased today may help us get there. We are ready to start the process of modernizing our supports through available technologies. Won't be easy, and there's a lot to do. We are committed to thinking through how to best foster independence in a way that is planned and person-centered and is safe.
Big pat on the back and a high five for the department down here. We met with them in May of this year when they first started kicking this idea around bringing the technology services down here, and it has gone fast. We've done this, and I've worked with about 15 different states right now that are funding these types of services that we're talking about today, and I've never seen any state move as fast as Tennessee.
Initially, when we rolled out this service, people only envisioned cameras. They had pictures of cameras being in their house and looking at them all the time, watching every move, and they were going to be trapped under these Big Brother-like cameras. And we really did a lot of work with the support of our vendor community, with support of county boards, with support of people using the service to explain that's not what this is. Video monitoring may be a component of this service, but it's certainly not all it does, and that's not the only kind of technology.
We need to have an emphasis on intellectual and developmental disabilities that's never had before, because we got the foundation built. And you know, we've got a provider network in this state that I am so proud of. Everywhere you go, it's better than it was last year. And last year was better than it was the year before.